Are you wondering if you need to provide a nest box for your Coturnix quail and exactly what kind of nest box do you need? Well, I'm going to talk about it in today's video and get it all cleared up for you. Hey guys, welcome back to another Slightly Rednecked video. Again, my name is Chris. If you're not familiar with this channel, I help you to produce your own meat, eggs, and vegetables from your backyard, your balcony, your deck, your garage, or heck, even a spare room in your house if that's the way you want to do it. Today, I'm getting ready to collect eggs right before church this morning. I thought, you know, I get a lot of questions about whether Coturnix quail need a nest box or not, and if so, what kind of nest box can you provide for them? And I thought, let's just address that in a video as I collect the eggs. So, first of all, quail are not like chicken, especially Coturnix quail. They have been domesticated for so long that they pretty much won't go broody like a chicken would. So with a chicken, you put a nest box in there, they go into the nest box, they build a nest, they lay their eggs in it, they might go broody, sit on those eggs, incubate them out, and hatch them out. Not the case with Coturnix quail. I'm not saying it doesn't happen ever, because it has happened. There have been quail that have gone broody, that have sat on their eggs, have incubated them out, and hatched them out. You typically don't get fantastic hatch rates whenever you do it that way. They just don't have that instinct much anymore. So it's a very rare thing for you to get a quail that's going to go broody. So with that being said, if you do decide to put a nest box in there, there's a good chance that they'll lay most of their eggs in the nest box. But I don't use a nest box, I use just a sandbox in mine, and most of the eggs get laid in there, but not all of them. And let me show you what I mean here. We'll bring you in close while I collect eggs. We'll show you where all the eggs are. This side of my hutch over here has got a nest box in it where most of the eggs get laid. And this side over here is just open wire. So let me bring you in close here. We'll show you kind of what I'm talking about. All right, so as I open this up here, we're gonna see, hopefully, there we go. Get back, buddy, get back. There we go. Most of the eggs, in fact, almost all of them, got laid in this box right here. And I'm out of sand. I need to get some more sand in here for them. But even without sand, they're going to lay most of their eggs right inside this box right here, which makes it easy to collect. So although it's not really a nest box, it's probably a good idea to go ahead and add something like this to your quail hutch. And again, just fill it with sand, fill it with you know, wood ash would be fine. Anything like that, even just dirt would be fine to fill it with. And that's where most of your eggs are going to get laid, and they're usually going to be pretty clean. Right now it's not, because I don't have any sand in there, so they're still kind of dirty right now. Let me put these eggs up. Now again, they don't, you can see they were just kind of spread out all over the place. They weren't collected together in one spot like a broody hen would do, where they collect their eggs together to sit on them to incubate them. So again, it's not really a nest box, it's just a sand box. Now what I still have to do is kind of check the corners here, because a lot of the times they will lay eggs outside of that box and they'll just be all over the place. And let me take you over to the other side too. All right, this is the side with the feet in it. And you can see all my quail running around. They like to jump up on these feeders. A lot of times I'll get eggs laid right on top of the feeders here. And I only got one out here this morning. Most of the time I'm going to have two or three eggs laid out in this open area right here. They just don't even lay it in the box itself. Sometimes more than that, sometimes less than that. Let me get this closed up and we'll discuss a few more ideas on this. Okay, so you can see that whenever I collected these eggs, they're just kind of spread out all over the place. They're not really laid in any one particular place. The hens don't really build a nest, so to speak. If you were to put straw or something like that in there, they'll pick through it, they'll throw it all over the place, but they won't really build a nest. So you don't need to worry about any kind of special nest box for your quail or anything like that, because they really won't use it. If you have extended, you know, off to the side with ramps that go up to it, like you'd see in a lot of like chicken coops, quail probably won't use that at all. They're ground dwellers. They don't go up high to roost. They don't go into nest boxes necessarily. They do like to lay in these sandboxes over on this side, but again, it's not really a nest box. So it's not something that you actually need for your Coturnix quail. Now again, that's not to say your Coturnix quail won't ever go broody, because it has happened from time to time, but it's a very, very rare thing. Out of all the quail I've ever kept, I had one hen one time that I thought might be going broody. She was moving the eggs around, kind of pushing them together, and I thought she might be going broody. She never ended up sitting on them. She never ended up doing any kind of thing like that, and she kept on laying eggs on a regular basis. So she didn't actually go broody, but she kind of displayed the characteristics, or the traits, like she was going to go broody, possibly. So, you know, it could happen. You might be able to incubate out. I've had a couple of my viewers talk about, they've had a broody hen that incubated out some chicks and hatched them out, but your hatch rates are usually pretty poor from that, you're best off, if you want to hatch quail, get an incubator and incubating them yourself. You're going to do a much better job. There has been some success reported about taking quail eggs under a broody bantam hen, and they'll incubate them out for you. So that's been successful. I've heard those reports before. Other than that, it's usually just incubating the eggs yourself to get them to hatch. These hens won't go broody. Don't need a nest box. Let me know in the comments below, have you had a different experience? Have you had a hen that's gone broody and has actually hatched out their own eggs? Or have you had success with building a nest box and having them actually go into the nest box and build a nest? In my experience, they don't do it. They lay their eggs there maybe, but they don't actually build a nest, and it's just a little bit extra work that you don't need to go through. Sandboxes work just fine. You can use just about anything you want for that. So thank you guys so much for watching this video, for keeping up with my content. If you're brand new here, hit that subscribe button below and keep up with all my updates. Let me know what you'd like to see in future videos. Join us on Thursday nights. Thursday nights right now, I'm doing a 7 o'clock Central Time live broadcast where I answer pretty much every comment, every question that comes through. It lasts for about 45 minutes to an hour. And as always, guys, God bless.